Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Well, we're still waiting for the next video to cross 5,000 likes. Seems to be the trend lately, but yesterday was a holiday, of course, and we had an awesome run on the second half of yesterday's run, admittedly so, but man, you gotta love that Diplopia play. I did. I know a lot of people did as well. We have a new meme of the day here, brought to you by, once again, Sabaz1727, who might be the only meme maker active right now on the Mosh Pit subreddit. Top thread was Invicta Luck. Never ask a woman her age. Never ask a man his salary. Never ask Invicta how many full clears we're going to run. Look, as Invicta myself, I think I should be able to find out, or at least be able to ask how many full clears we had. Because I'd like to know. It's got to be more than, like, I would say on average probably two or three. There's going to be two Whiskey Charlie Yankee. Golf 8 Charlie Yankee. Lots of Charlie Yankees out there. We've got Doctor's Remote, which is essentially a on-use Epic Fetus. And then we also have Mom's Razor Blade, which is not a great item. But, you know, it's whatever, you know. It's the start of an Eden run. We also have really good tears rate. Actually, fantastic tears rate, 3.37 combined with 3.88 damage. So a good starting base here anyway. Secret room should be to the left of the sack room, maybe. There's a little bit of HP here along with some shot speed. Shot speed was actually quite low, so I'm happy to see that. And, yeah, it's a good start here to what is supposedly maybe even, I would say, hypothetically going to be an amazing run, because they all are amazing, right? Secret room actually could probably be there as well. They look for confirmation on the side room, the room below us. So that will tell us exactly what we've need or what we got. An extra bomba. Okay, so yeah, so it's not there. The super secret room is going to be to the right of here, though. We know that because, well, there's only one room that it could possibly be adjacent to. This is a flat room here. Plus, I've seen this tile set a million billion times, so... I'm actually going to use a bomb. I'm not going to use our Doctor's Remote for this because I want to use the Doctor's Remote against the boss. Now, also, we have this Tinted Rock here as well. So let's go see who the boss is. Boss is going to be. Get one of them. It's going to be Gurglings. Could I have gotten away with not using Doctor's Remote? Yeah, probably, and saved ourselves a bomb on the Tinted Rock, but eh. Another HP upgrade here, and it gives us, Lucky Rock. Now we're talking. Okay, so this will give us a chance to get coins every time we destroy a rock or pot or skull or anything like that. And look at that, we have exactly 15 cents, so we can go into the shop and get a premium item, which if we wanted to. And hey, look at that, it's the return of deep pockets, and I will absolutely take that. So our money is now going to start, hopefully, theoretically anyway, skyrocketing. And yeah. This is one heck of a good start. Curse of the Unknown. Well, the thing that we do know is we have two red hearts, and that's the only thing that really truly matters. As long as we don't take a whole lot of damage on this floor, which we really shouldn't, then we should be okay. So now that we have the Lucky Rock, this essentially gives our space bar item that we started with a lot more added value, and that's important. That's another one of those aspects of Isaac that, you know, you don't really think a whole lot about on a day-to-day basis unless you're just a giant nerd like I am. And this is something that, you know, you can have a speculative value of, like, say, like a synergy that, you know, that you've seen before, like, you know, you have, oh, well, you know, if we could get double brimstone, that'd be great. You know, if we could get magic mush to go along with our mini mush or to go along with Jacob's ladder, that would be great and everything like that. But this is one of those synergies where you don't really see the potential until you have it. And here we now get plenty of value out of using our space bar item consistently and always, basically always, as long as it's on a, I don't know if it's there or not. It could be there as well, it being the secret room. I'm going to use our Doctor's Remote here first just because I was going to try to get ourselves a couple extra cents, but fortunately Lucky Rock had other plans. Yeah, so we know that the secret room is not going to be here, or at least it shouldn't be anyway because of the presence of the spider webs on the side walls there. Now, in Repentance, that may have changed a little bit. Anyway, going back to the synergies that I was talking about just a second ago, this now gives our added value even more value here, because now, on top of us not having to use any bombs anymore, at least theoretically anyway, for every two rooms. We now have the option of making money off of that, which then leads to other stuff. Like, our early game economy now increases, and we can get more things to out of the store. We can get more premium items. We can get, you know, if we happen to get the member card, then we can get even more value out of that. So, you know, there's a lot of things. It's a cascade of effects whenever you do get a positive synergy between items. And in this case, Lucky Rock giving us a huge amount of value out of our space bar item, which was already very good. So, you know, it's a big time get for us. Is what I'm trying to say.
My God,
it's Pin. So I'm not going to use our Epic Fetus / Doctor's Remote for Pin, just because we shouldn't ever need to use it there unless I just felt lazy or we didn't have damage. A matchbook, which is going to give us one black soul heart and some more bombas. We get Money Equals Power along with Spirit of the Night. Both of these are excellent to get for us. So I'm going to take Spirit of the Night, then we're going to use the Strength card, then we're going to take Money Equals Power. So we will now gain damage every time we get money. We know it. We take it out of our pockets and show it and throw it like. On top of that, remember, we now have even more incentive to go use our to use Doctor's Remote on basically every single rock that we can find. Look at this. This is just going to make our damage go up and up and up, something that we definitely need. And especially with us having more bombs and stuff here, this is also going to help us out greatly. Ooh. I do like me some card reading. Hive Mind also wouldn't be bad. I don't like bombing the donation machine this early, but I think this is a special case where we could definitely get away with taking both of these. Now, obviously, this is going to completely nuke our damage, but remember, this is only a temporary setback because we're going to be able to create more money out of essentially what is nothing. Like, we can use Doctor's Remote here in this cluster of rocks, and hey, look at that. We gained 4 cents. We're already back up over four damage again. So, yeah, this is a good start. Okay, so now I'll get to show you basically what we can... We have two options here when you have card reading. Card reading will give us... I'm gonna pause for a second so I can explain without having to worry about the boss rush. The card reading is going to give you three portals. It's going to give you a blue one or a yellow one or a red one or a combination of two of the three. Okay, so what's nice about having the red portal is that you do get to go straight to the boss. The bad thing is that obviously you're missing out on items that could have helped you against the boss. Now, of course, you can always backtrack afterward unless you're going into a boss room that doesn't allow you to backtrack. But in this case, I think it's better for us to go straight to the boss only because of the fact that A, we have no mapping, B, it's early enough to where, and we have enough damage to really thrive against early game bosses. And also, it will tell us most of the time, not all the time, but most of the time, the boss room, wow, I didn't even see that shot. Most of the time, the boss room is located somewhat similarly close to the shop. And then, you know, backtracking is also in our favor, too, because of Deep Pockets plus Money Equals Power plus Lucky Rock, et cetera, et cetera. So you see we're having a really nice money synergy to go along with this build right now. And that's a good thing. You want to be in that spot. You want to be in a position in Isaac where you have so many options you don't even know what to do with. That's a good place to be. These are good problems to have. It's like, you know, well, do we want to go to the item room for free or do we want to go to the boss room? Or do we want to go here or do we want to go there? You know, do we want to use our bombs here for this rock or should we wait? I get a little bit of extra bleeding damage on Gertie if we can. Yeah, the pooters can actually shoot through Gertie, which is kind of BS-y, but, you know. That's Isaac, baby! Alright, so we're going back here. Now we can really start exercising not only the amount of strength that we get from mobility-wise from flying, but also, of course, the spectral tiers, which will allow us to shoot through environmental objects, so we don't have to worry about, like, positioning and whatnot. As long as we are in range of stuff, then, you know, that's all we need to do. I don't feel like messing with fatty baddies, especially with kind of our floaty shots right now. Get divorce papers, which is a very good upgrade for us, by the way. Okay, so here I'd love to get both of these. I'd love to get the membership card, because the membership card is going to give us even more options to buy stuff. Plus, it's not out of the question that we aren't going to have plenty of money here. With a combination of deep pockets, lucky rock, basically unlimited bombs, et cetera, et cetera. That blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean. Wow. Okay. I like how the needles, they can somehow bounce higher when you shoot them. It's like you're propping them up with your shots in the air. I like to do that a lot. Again, flying, such a huge, huge, huge benefit. Unfortunately, there's no rocks in here, so I was really hoping that we were going to see a bunch of rocks, then I could just use the doctor's remote and get some free stuff, but apparently not. I don't really think that like we should be using bombs on rocks. This is the nice thing about this, is that we're not in any pressured, hurried state to have to use every single bomb that we can, right? We can backtrack and then go blow up the rocks that are like are better value, or like have higher clusters of rocks that we have the best chance of making the most money off of. Like this room right here would not be a bad room to use Doctor's Remote, for example. We can get basically what is essentially a free Doctor's Remote in here twice, because there's another full charge, but I'd rather use this full charge to blow up other rocks. Again, we're looking to maximize profits here to get as much money as we can from Lucky Rock. Like, 2 cents. No? Yeah, 2 cents, you know? Yeah, look at that. All right. Well, still looking for that item room. Now that we've gone through like a double wide Isaac circle, we'll get one extra penny. Remember, every single cent that we pick up is going to be more damage, and more damage is always good. As luck would have it, we get the map where the item room was not near to the boss, but in fact the furthest possible spot that it could have been. So big bomb here. I don't want to have to use our bombs until necessary. We do get a movement speed, which was actually, like, I'm not hating the movement speed. We kind of needed it. Go for a little bit of extra spice here. We get one whole cent. There we go. That's more what we want. It's supposed to be 50-50, by the way. Sorry, 33% chance. I'm thinking of the golden one, I guess. Yeah, we can afford to go in here for half of a soul heart. We essentially gain 1.5 soul hearts out of that, so pretty good deal. We're gonna gain even more soul hearts out of this this challenge room too. So yeah, 6.6 damage. Got another use here of Doctor's Remote, so we can use this on any rocks that we want to, or we can use it offensively, obviously, but we shouldn't need the offense. With our damage approaching 7, we should be okay. Secret room might be here. Not there. Maybe it's between this room and the shop. Really wasn't here? Okay. Well, let's buy a member card first. This is gonna be the time we have the most money right now. And we get, I mean, 26 cents for the mystery gift when it usually sells for 15. Kind of highway robbery game, I'm not gonna lie. Buy this extra soul heart, why not? We get the blue one. Now, the blue one is going to take us to the secret room. The yellow one's going to take us to the item room. In this case, I think it's in our best interest to go to the secret room. It doesn't really matter. We have equal bombs and keys, so we'll go to the item room. Bomb bag. I mean, normally I'd be against this because of the bomb bag's tendency to drop a whole bunch of troll bombs, but because we have Lucky Rock, this is going to give us even more of a chance to get even more money that we can spend in the membership shop or, of course, to power up our damage. So we want to try to finagle these Globins into a little circle here. Don't ask me how they all slide, even though they're incapacitated and not being hit. It's best not to try to think about Isaac's physics. Isaac physics, they can't hurt you. They don't exist. Bomb bag. Okay. First, the maze just clearly does not want us to utilize our advantages here. Super secret room is guaranteed to be right here. I say guaranteed there because I've seen this tile a million billion times, and there's also, generally speaking, there's also not a good amount of chances for you to use it, to find it on a map that's shaped like this. Anywhere close to this close to the boss room. First the maze, you need to calm down. Like, it could be north of here, but it's very rare to see the super secret room north of that particular room tile. Okay, let's go fight the boss. Don't be Gerda Jr. Earth Hormones gives movement speed and damage. And I will take Guppy's Hairball.
The Hermit.
A champion belt for sure. Soap is a good tiers up. We can come up with 7 more cents. I want to get soap to max out our tiers rate for sure. For sure. So these guys are exploding champions as they should be. Trying to get them around the rocks here. Or they're just immortal and they cannot be killed at all. Thank you. Secret room is right here. Game has to sneak the secret room into this little area. Go champion belt, gonna give us another much needed damage upgrade here. We have a little bit of a target prioritization problem, whether or not we want to use the doctor's remote for clearing enemies and stuff, or use them for trying to get more money to boost up our damage. It really comes down to what you decide. Okay, we do get a red portal here in Necropolis. I am going to take it because we weren't right next to the item room anyway. We could tell because obviously we can see the other rooms that are adjacent to where we started with. So I'm going to take the boss, even though we don't have a full charge on the on Doctor's Remote here. Trying to get hit by this spike. Then we can backtrack and go to our item room here. Oh, wow, we got another tiers up. I am going to use a bomb for this one. Obviously, tiers up doesn't matter because we're already capped. We'll take Eye of Belial. Eye of Belial is going to give us, again, another nice piercing shot to go along with our spectral tier, so we now have spectral and piercing, which is very good. And we've caught up to where we could probably make boss rush. There's a spectral champion right there. I think it's just the eagle that or egg. It's like Eggert or Eggle or whatever. I don't know what they're called. I just call them egglets. I'm pretty sure that the yellow spiders, the little yellow ones, they cannot actually inherit the champion's abilities. That would be pretty like horrific if they could. Like, if they turn into like also little green champions, the one that multiply and stuff. Yeah. No, thank you. Now we have Jar of Flies, which is actually a little bit more tempting to me than having Doctor's Remote, because now we don't necessarily need all that damage or the free bombs, because Jar of Flies will make up for that, because we have Hive Mind. And Hive Mind Jar of Flies is a considerable amount of damage, especially if we're going to be hovering around 7 or even higher than that. So while, yes, it is nice having the explosive, oh my goodness. if the D-Sizzle is just going to show up like that, then I guess we got to go with the D-Sizzle. Okay. Well, Jar of Flies, it was great seeing you, and we thank you for your time and effort, and we look forward to seeing what you can accomplish in the future. Okay, now unfortunately we do not have the Fool card, so we cannot take the portal into Oh my god. Okay. I don't know what's even going on anymore this run. First we get the D-Sizzle out of nowhere, and all of a sudden, like, here's just Death Certificate sitting right in the secret room. Okay, well, first things first, I'm the realist. Second things first, we gotta find where the tinted skull is so we can get out of this boss rush. Oh, you can get a Soul of Eden, too. Interesting. So, now we need to start making some plans here. It's time to have a little sit-down and chat about what we're going to do. Because with Death Certificate, everything is now on the table for us. Everything. Literally in the game, everything. So, what do we want? Do we want damage? Do we want, you know, rock bottom? Rock bottom with this particular setup wouldn't be bad, because we wouldn't be able to lose any of the stats that we gain from Money Equals Power, regardless of how much money we have, up to the point of us taking Death Certificate. I don't think we're going to make boss rush here, because we can't find the gosh dang Tinted Skull. So I'm leaning towards rock bottom, even though we did have a video earlier this year talking about how rock bottom isn't necessarily always going to be the slam dunk choice. Come on, man. Where is the Tinted Skull? You're going to do us like this, game? You're going to do us dirty like this? Yep, they're going to do us dirty like that. All right, so boss rush is now off the table, which is annoying. We can actually bomb our way into the mob trap room. Already maxed on here, so. So if we were to take Death Certificate from, or if we were to take Rock Bottom from Death Certificate, we would need to essentially take it before we spend any money in the store. But there's so many other options that we could take. I mean, we could take Brimstone if we wanted to. We could take, you know, Spoonbender. We could take Sissy. Polyphemus, Sacred Heart. I mean, this is the reason why I don't like open world games, because when I'm presented with too many choices, then I can't make a decision on a choice. The tinted skull is literally going to be next to our item room, isn't it? Or inside of the item room for even added effect. I think the one that makes the... Yep, there it is right there. Because like I said, I think the one that makes the most sense is Rock Bottom. Rock Bottom on a run that can start out like this would be pretty tough to beat. But again, if we're going to take Rock Bottom, we need to do it before we spend any money in the store. So I think Rock Bottom is the play here. Yeah, we get damage. D6, by the way, is a item that's going to reroll any pedestal item that we see in the room. Gives another random item. Let's rip death certificate. Magic Mush is also certainly an option, but again, why take that when we could have Rock Bottom, which would stop us from losing any stats and essentially just give us the damage that we can get from Money Equals Power. That way our as soon as we take Rock Bottom, as soon as I find it, our damage can no longer go down from what it's set at. We're going to be getting more money here, more bombs. Oh man, I love it. I don't know what happens if you use the Soul of Eden inside of a death certificate room. I want to believe that it wouldn't just yeet you out of the room, but I also don't trust repentance, so... A Sacred Heart, of course. Your eyes are immediately drawn to it, but that's not what we're looking for here. All the way in the corner. Rock freaking bottom. But now we are free to pick up money, use bombs, and not have to worry about our damage ever going below 9.27. So what Rock Bottom essentially does is it locks your damage, all your stats, to whatever your stats were set at the time of you acquiring Rock Bottom, and it can no longer, this goes for all stats, it can no longer go below those no matter what. No matter what items you take, no matter how much money you spend, it's going to be, we're locked. So notice how our damage is not going to go down. Now, our damage will not go up until after we've crossed the 9.91 threshold, which was, I think, that set us at like, we took it at what, like 75 cents or something like that? Gonna smelt the small rock, or the lucky rock, I should say. I mean, Dreamcatcher, eh. Mom's Key is very good. Movement speed, our movement speed's okay right now. We get a dice shard, take that. We can actually use the dice shard now if we want to. Dice. And we get Diplopia, which, yeah. Use Diplopia in here. Joker card. Okay, so even though we spent all of our money, almost all of our money, notice how our stats, our damage has not gone down. That's how essentially Rock Bottom works. Now, again, the only thing is here is that we will not gain any stats, any damage from Money Equals Power until after we've crossed whatever the money was set at when we picked it up. It was like 75 cents. Because remember, keep in mind our damage technically is not 9.91 right now. It's 9.91 minus whatever we spent in the store. So once we crossed that, I think we were at 75 or 76 cents, something like that, before we started rolling and picked up Trinket Smelter. When we get past that, that's when Rock Bottom will start allowing our damage to go back up. This will then be crossing the 9.91 damage that it was currently set at. So now obviously it's going to go up because we take the negative, and then that moves the bar to where from where our damage was before we picked up the negative to now whatever the difference is between 9.91 and whatever it is after we take the negative. I know it sounds confusing. So the threshold of money that we need to start going back up is now been altered because we got another damage up. Double tinted rock. Got one of them there double tinted rocks. A whole bunch of stuff in there. I'm taking a look at the famine ain't bad because we do have hive mind. So theoretically, we shouldn't need 75 cents, 76 cents, whatever it was now, in order to start seeing our damage go back up. We need more like 60 cents or something like that. Maybe close to like 65 cents because of the negative raising our damage floor, as it were. No. I mean, we can take pills. Never take pills, ever, even with rock bottom.
We just went another soul heart. That's all we wanted.
67%. It's green bloat. He is super slow. I don't know what got him so slow, but whatever. Another HP upgrade. I'm going to hold off on that. The Guppy's Tail, which is great for us considering the fact that we have Mom's Key or Babylon. We'll take both of these since essentially that was a free devil deal and went on his own. So I come away with the blue portal here. 2 of 3 for Guppy. Greed Fight. I mean, Greed Fight's going to be okay because he's most likely going to drop money here. Now remember, here we go again. Keep in mind that our damage floor has been raised now because we have Horror Babylon activated. And despite us not being in the Horror Babylon state anymore, Rock Bottom is preventing our stats from going down from what it was when we were in that state. Which is why Rock Bottom is great, because it's like, hey, your stats have been here. Guess what? They can't go below here. They can only go up. Gotta be careful about not over-rotating against Mom's Heart. You get another devil deal. And we did not get Guppy. However, we get bad PhD or false PhD, which allows us to get pills and not suffer the stats down. So this speed down right here, it says minus 0.12 speed, 0.6 damage upgrade. Nah, fam. We're just going to take that damage upgrade and keep our speed. How about that? How about that? So now we're guaranteed damage ups from the pills that are supposed to lower our stats as compensation to the game. Now we say, no, no, no. There's no more fair compensation. It's now all compensation, all benefits, I should say, directly to us. We need to get a full charge here on the D6 before we leave, just in case we do get a red portal from in the dark chest, thanks to card reading. Gonna do that real quick. You know, notice how we are now starting to get damage. Notice that our scents are not at 70 some odd. That's because our floor raised. So we're now in the process. We are at the level of being able to gain damage from coins again. So hopefully that illustrates what I was kind of like getting at earlier. I know it sounded a little bit convoluted, but I tried to explain it the best I can. We did not get a red portal, unfortunately. And we did not get Guppy either. Could take Pogatory. These aren't super stellar. I mean, taking Hive Mind or Host Hat. Taking Host Hat's fine for the explosion immunity for sure. Damage up. Damage up. And I think it's in our best interest to... We can use this Devil card for sure, the Joker card for sure. But it's in our best interest to get a reroll just because we're trying to get... Come on. We're trying to get that Guppy item. We can actually take Curse the Tower since we're not... We have nothing... We have no fear of hitting ourselves with explosions. So if we do take damage, we're going to be dropping bombs left and right. Not that I'm trying to do that, but, you know. Okay. You know what? I think we'll just wait. Let's go fight Lamb, and then we'll use the Joker card on the victory lap. How about that? Sinus infection really slows them down that much? They stack like that? I guess I never really truly paid attention to the slowing benefits of sinus infection on targets. Look at that. It's dealing constant damage over time. More dots. More dots. Second seed of the day today, Delta 747 Golf Quebec Whiskey Hotel. Let's go in the item room. Oh, yeah, that's right. It doesn't work when you're on victory lap. That's right. It's the only time that that card reading does not work is if you're on a victory lap and it's on the first floor. So, of course, we don't get to go, but oh well. Burnt Penny. Might be able to reroll that. Might could. Yeah, I really don't want the Burnt Penny here. It's not that I'm afraid of the bombs this time around, it's just that the flies that we get are really freaking nice. The flies plus damage is just nice. And plus, like, we don't need moms, especially with us having Mom's Key and Guppy's Tail. Okay, so I am going to buy the Mystery Gift. We don't need Lord of the Pit because we already have flying, obviously. And then what we can do is we can go into... I'm going to be a little lazy here. We can go into here. Do that. We get Cracked Orb, which ain't bad. But... I want to see what we can get with the reroll, assuming that we don't get anything worthwhile from the Devil deal, which I will use the Joker card momentarily to determine, but go fight the boss real quick, see if we can get some HP. Look at that. Look how much damage that the Locust did. Yeah, whatever. The range up here, tier size up. Okay, so let's go check out the Devil deal first. And, of course, it's a Krampus fight because, you know. Yeah. Lumbicol is actually fine with Eye of Belial. Dad's Ring, which... And PH Dizzle. Buy the blanket. PhD, I guess. I say I guess because, like, it doesn't really truly matter. We do not want the car battery. I'll take a soul heart. Another hive mind. Hive mind, to my knowledge, doesn't stack. Yeah. Pepper cables is good. I was kind of hoping for some kind of mapping, but, you know. Curse of Blind, hooray. Makes this floor quite easy. Yeah, unfortunately, as much as I would love to, we can't really take any of those. I mean, Curse of the Blind, it just ruins everything. I'd love to take all three of those blind, but on top of, like, the fact that it would kill us, we just can't do it. Here's nails. Now you might be wondering, hey, wait a second, isn't that supposed to be a damage upgrade? Well, let me tell you something, 1920s brother. It is a damage upgrade, but remember, our damage is currently Eclipse. It's not currently 13.21 in the background. It's being masked by what our damage was at its highest. So we have to catch up in the damage upgrades department before we start seeing any benefits from actual damage ups. Again, any damage up that we get is just going to raise the floor, our damage floor. Yeah. Now, we could take Trisagion. Trisagion wouldn't actually negatively impact us because of Rock Bottom, but it's still, like, you know, not great. Plus, it does have a tendency to crash the game, which is not ideal, obviously. I still really just kind of want Guppy if we can get it. Looking for a nickel out of that. Hey. And we don't have to worry about explosions because of Host Hat. Ooh, Lusty Blood is nice with Rock Bottom. Oh, Sack Dagger, how the mighty have fallen. Like, Sack Dagger is still good, obviously. It's just not as good. Another champion Mega Fatty here. And look at the damage. The absolute trucking done by Sinus Infection. The amount of damage that our tiers are doing over time with the Sinus Infection boogers attaching themselves to everything is just so satisfying. I mean, it took out, like, Lamb's upper half without us even doing anything. Lacrimogy plus Rock Bottom plus having Eye of Belial was not terrible. Remember, our tears won't slow down because of the fact that we have Rock Bottom, so it's not that big of a deal. We do get Guppy in the most weird way possible. So as long as we're holding on to a child's drawing, we will be able to maintain Guppy. But Lacrimogy also gives us an opportunity to kind of, like, just beef up our damage even more now because we're shooting the tiers into other tiers, and then when they finally do explode, they're going to be dealing buku amounts of damage. Yeah. Especially when we're firing them on top of a Sinus Infection booger. So I'm going to take Guppy's head only because I want to get Guppy without having to worry about maintaining Guppy, and then we can take we'll take Bogatory too. Bogatory's aight. Yeah, I want to see what this damage can do to Beast. Old Beastie. We don't need red hearts anymore. I want to see what Sinus Infection plus Lacrimogy can do to Old Beastie. And Dogma, too. I mean, who doesn't like beating Dogma? There's a statement for the t-shirt right there. Oh, which reminds me, I got the September box in from the Maestro Media Isaac subscription service. So it'll be a dual. I know I didn't end up putting one out for August, but it'll be a dual. It'll be a dual box opening for August and September sub boxes. Don't worry about all the money. We'll come back and pick it up. I'm just looking for the item room right now. There we go. Curse the tower, getting us some extra money. Trying to get our damage benefits back up. Oh man, this run really, really came together. Definitely would not mind having Bookworm either. This will get us Bookworm. We can actually use the Book of Belial to up our damage as well. Okay, well, I tried. That will raise our damage floor, though. So we're getting... Well, we're still quite a bit of ways from actually getting benefit out of Money Equals Power. Glitter bombs, they're very sparkly and pink. Keep those bombs in there. Bombs will remain forever unexploded. Let those spike rocks just sit in purgatory and bomb purgatory. We could roll for another full charge, I think. Nope. Yep. Well, do we want to use that in there? Or do we want to use it in here? Big fan, I don't really care about. We could buy the Soul of Isaac as well. Fear of Destiny. Yeah, Cat and Nine Tails, I guess. It's going to give us more shot speed, which is fine for lack of G, but let's re-roll this chest in here. Montezuma's Revenge. Now you're speaking my language. Montezuma's Revenge plus Guppy. Oh, baby. Okay, so we're going to forego using our red portal here. Because again, we want to get out of boss rush, but also want to get out of the mom fight if we're going to be fighting old Beastie. Now, could we go into Beast Room right now? Yes, we could. Ace of Diamonds. Yeah, fine. Ace of Diamonds. Yeah, look at that. Now we've raised it to the point where we're already gaining money. We don't even have 50 cents yet. I can see forever. Hoping we get some good money out of this eternal chest. Seeing the fly generation come off of Montezuma's Revenge as well. Again, it's just really good. I mean, Montezuma's Revenge is just top tier. What can I say? It is the top of the top tier in terms of tier effects. Fun to use, albeit challenging, but man, is it rewarding whenever you get like a huge chain off and you just nuke everything that's in front of you with Montezuma's Revenge. Old Razor Blade, Can we use this? We can use this for boosting our damage up by a whole lot. Because we probably aren't going to need money for anything else at this point. We don't, I mean, even though Death's Touch is nice and all, I think the Golden Razor Blade actually gives us more damage here. Yeah. Raise our damage by a bunch, okay. His mom. He's Paul. We don't really need. Sci-fly. Yeah, come on down, Sci-fly. I ain't gonna reroll you, bud. I ain't rerolling you, buddy. Basically, every 5 cents that we get is gonna be just more. More damage for us. Flat file. Actually, know what? No, it won't. It's gonna take us like, because our floor has been raised, or our ceiling now has been raised so much by us using the Golden Razor Blade that it would actually take. Whatever, however many times we use it in there, I think it was, what, 9 times? It would take that plus another one. So it would take 50 cents in order for us to gain benefit out of it. So get a dice shard here. Okay. Okay. All right. Well, I tried. Take a big time rock bottom plays. Let's go smash Beastie here and see what kind of damage we can do with Lacrophagy and Sinus Infection. Now, there is one more store, but I'm going to elect not to use it if we get the red portal, which we did. Here we go.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
Our savings. Please. Had we taken Death's Touch, we could have gotten true piercing shots instead of like the sort of pseudo piercing that we've got with Compound Fracture is pretty good. It would take a lot for me to take something over Spoonbender, but Compound Fracture, yeah, Compound Fracture is pretty good with the Eye of Belial and, more importantly, Lacrophagy. We go in that item room? I don't think we did. Yeah, I think I may have screwed myself out of an item. Look at who we have to look up to. You're trying to get on you. Shut up, man. Shut up. Just keep pushing me like this. I'm leaving.
Good. Leave. We'll be fine without you. Abandon us like the bandit himself.
Apparently there's no item room on this floor. Interesting. Oh no, there it is. Yeah. I may have gotten my rooms mixed up there. We didn't go. Did we go to the item room on Depths 2? I don't remember now. You're seeing how much craziness it's flying all over the room here. If it opens, that means that we've already been in there. heard that dime sound. We're up at 84. Now, again, it's going to require quite a bit of money for us to gain any benefit now from Money Equals Power, because our ceiling has raised so much. So yeah, we're over $1 and still no benefit. That's probably gonna remain like that until about like $1.50, $1.60 around there. I gotta say that Deep Pockets was definitely one of the big time players, but that random death certificate, man. When stuff like that happens, you gotta take the opportunity. No, it's like a once in a blue moon type deal. Play-Doh cookie. I don't mind Play-Doh cookie here because we have explosion immunity, obviously. Most of the time, I do mind Play-Doh cookie. I think it's quite awful. I like the idea of the item. I just don't like the fact that it can proc Fire Mind. Fire Mind is the problem. Play-Doh cookie. Sun card didn't do anything. I feel it's just gonna be straight back here, isn't it? Yep. To the ascent we go. All right, we get one more opportunity here. Might as well fill up on soul hearts. And I am looking forward to seeing what old beasties. Gonna get hit with your strength card. And we don't really need to use the strength card. We don't like the extra damage is nice, but it's not gonna go over what our current ceiling is. Actually that was probably a horrible idea. Tech Zero probably is going to crash the game. I'm anticipating it crashing the game. Okay, we got through Dogma, but that doesn't mean anything because now we're gonna have to deal with Tech Zero attaching itself to all the tears flying around the room, as well as the sinus infection boogies. Okay, well down goes Ultra Famine. He didn't make it. Okay, Pestilence also didn't make it. By the way, notice how our Montezuma's Revenge tiers are also going to get... They also get the Lackergy effect. Mega War, Ultra War didn't make it. Here comes Ultra Death. He also did not make it. All right. And here comes Old Beastie. There you go, Pogatory. Hey, phase two. And she's dead. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. Man, what a good run that was. You gotta love it. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked the video. And of course, leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite preferred item to pick from Death Certificate is. I'd love to read those kind of comments. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, everyone. Happy Tuesday. Hope you had a great start to it. Don't forget to check out the Three Guys Talk About Football podcast coming up sometime, probably tomorrow, I'm guessing, whenever Coach Crendor decides to release it. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank the patrons of mine like Dennis Zubko, Monty Dickey, Michael McMaster, Oliver Wendt, Ashlyn West, and Josue Contreras. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.